So, this is where we're going to start the recording. Because I tend to forget, and that's not good. So, I'm just taking out the last of the references that I had for this one. Not that one. So, I had another reference that I wanted to use, that one. There we go. So, now I got everything I need. Just need to get the right size. And we can do the painting. Have some fun. Hopefully you guys will have as fun as I am having. Okay, so I need to put that one on a... There we go. This way I can see things and I can still paint in front of you guys and everything can be nice and dandy. I'm gonna save this one as a corrected version. Right, so. And then we can do some of that, and some of this, and some of everything. Right, so this is going to be one big massive chisel, where we're gonna just fill out and make sure that everything looks spick and span. Let's try our best to make this one look good as well. I'm gonna maybe flatten out a little bit. So I need to make a little dragon here. So I have this spiral is the suggested reference that my client gave. So. See if we can get this one working proper. Okay, that's good. Just get some of this in there. But I'm gonna make, well, let me make it an open eye, why not? An open eye. A squee dragon was the word used. So we're gonna make it a little bit koi. How about that one? Koi is good. We like koi. Maybe like looking in this direction. Trying to make everything look as good as possible, but staying kind of loose, because if I start solidifying too much now, I'm just gonna spend loads of time on rendering. And I'm gonna try to not do the over rendering all the time thing. So maybe up here already. So I'm looking a little bit at the spiral reference, but I'm kind of trying to not do too much. If you know what I mean, it needs to look so. I can't steal spiral just right off, that's, you know, bad. Hello Felicity, I'm painting dragons. Well, your dragon. You have a day off or? Or you just drop by to say hi anyway? I'm very happy that you're here in any case. Regardless of which, little bit like that. No sound, okay. So, there we go. And try to get that entirety. So we're just slowly building up this this entire thing. As we are as one would do. Will the finished piece be in color or in black and white? Yes, it will be in color. I'm just doing the values right now. After that one, I'm gonna do a color pause. And then I'm gonna add a color pass using a color layer, and then after that one I will paint on top of that one to make everything look awesome. It's a bit fun. Having fun, hopefully doing some stuff. Am I not there we go. Had to add that one. So we add a little bit of this spikiness here. His spikiness. Checking a little bit on the higher note as well, on bigger scene, seeing what gives. Hopefully you like what you see already, Pickens. Thank you.
Alpha der Heide.
So, this is what we're doing. We're jigging it up, shaping it up. I'm gonna make this the tail go around here, I think. Yeah. Make the lion, make the dragon lie like a lion. something like this, kind of curling around. Reference for that one. Want this one. Oh, dude, why are you not working? Here we go. Excuse me while I sneeze. bum bum. It's a little bit of shame that Felicity can't hear me, because I could have asked loads of questions. But let's not change. Let's not negatively affect her workplace. Is this the right one? No, it's not. So it needs to be darker. But we're getting somewhere with this one. I believe. Something like this. Let's see who joined us. Someone joined us. Some person. A person that's not mentioned. Okay, you're welcome. Welcome to join us, person who is not mentioned. Big noses are fine. Okay, good. Here we go. Checking out Thronezilla, Flickums, electrical skateboard, electrical longboard. Electrical longboard, that's the same person, isn't it? It's alright, you're all welcome. Mm-hmm. bum 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 for the win. I'm searching a little bit for this face. I need to really make sure that it looks like a goblin. And that's a bit difficult. That is a little bit difficult. This might work. There we go, a little bit more. A little bit more like that. Perhaps. God, I'm very, very silent today. I'm sorry about that one. I'm trying my best, but I'm getting into a zone. And then when you're in the zone, you kind of go with it. Difficult trying to make sure that this looks really proper, like a female goblin as well, like a sorceress. Ah. Here we go. I think we're getting somewhere with this one. Thank you. you're on my left. Okay, cool. So now I can talk. Awesome. So I'm spending some time to try to make sure that this one really properly looks like a proper goblin. And it's working out nicely. However, I need to work on the hat a little bit, I think. Because the hat isn't going as I wanted to. Really? Excuse me. I wanted to sit a little bit lower. And hopefully feel a little bit more hatty. It needs to feel hatty. That's important. If it's not a hatty hat, then it's not a hat. Also, it cannot go that far out there. Because the way that a hat sits means that it will go here. It will stop there. If it goes further, then it's actually strong, then it's actually more in the front than in the back, and that's not good. And we work it up. Now I'm just gonna make a black field here. So how are you doing otherwise? You alright? How's your how's it going with the house? Have you plastered everything on the walls yet? Or papered everything or hung everything or is it hattiness is extremely important. I agree. It's if it's not hatty, then it's I don't know what it is. I think Neil regrets his decision to use wallpaper. Yeah. I have said we are gonna do some stuff in our house as well, and I have said I don't want wallpaper anymore. We both kind of agree on it though, but we've been talking about painting the walls and stuff like that. In Sweden, painting the walls is something that you just don't do. It doesn't happen. It's all wallpaper kind of. And so the entire notion of painting the walls was kind of weird for me to start off with. But wallpaper just bananas. It's just bananas. Well, you can. I mean, you can wallpaper. It's not like you can't wallpaper. Paint the walls. It's not like you can't paint the walls in Sweden. However, it's just very, very rarely done. So when you paint the walls and you get like a gravel thing happening, it's like a texture. That one mainly. Any other kind, it's just, you know, very, very rare. Okay, so here we go. And now to try to make this one look more like clothing. Swedish meatballs are nice. I hope that your only experience isn't just IKEA, because that's not a good representation. Swedish meatballs have in Belgium has a very interesting thing happening there. In Belgium, Swedish meatballs at IKEA, they Ooh, driving test 3 cities tomorrow. I really hope you can. I hope really you can pass that one as well. I'm glad that you get a chance to do that one. I know last time was hell because you had to do it in the middle of the snowstorm. No? That was not the nicest of situations. Okay, so moving it down there. What do I have here? Here we go. So oi, that's interesting. If you well, you know, I will never say no to more commissions. It's that simple. Just the fact that you could save yourself money in general is nice. Got a test in the early afternoon, so the roads will be quiet. That's really nice as well. I mean, it's not like you don't know how to drive. It's just getting past that pesky test. I know exactly how that one feels. So, in the front here, it will be slightly darker here. This is why I made these ones darker as well. And this is kind of why I'm doing this, particularly with painting something that is slightly more tongue-in-cheek or cute or less realistic maybe, but you know, doing the painting in the values first is really, really easy because I get easy see everything how everything flows and make sure that everything is correct and those kind of things. So it's it becomes a time saver. But I really hope you get the chance to do to pass the test, you know, because it makes life easier. Simple as that. That's so. I think we're gonna do that one, and I'm gonna save this one because let's save while we're winning. Trixie is a very cute character. Alright. Well, is this cute enough? That's my question, because I'm really trying my best, but it's always tricky to do people's favorite characters. That's one of the, it's like portraits. Portraits is like the worst. Can you send me a copy, please, so I can show Neil the Dragon? Absolutely. I'll just screenshot this one as is. And I'll Facebook it to you. Ozek. There you go. You should have it now. Let's see. Hopefully that one helps. So, need to make sure that everything works out nicely. So that's why I'm looking at this one now in black and white, because I'm trying to make sure that everything really drives home. So over here, for instance, you have like this area where I want the book to be darker than her clothes. So I can't make the things here, the clothes here too dark. But on the other hand, I cannot make it too bright either, because if I make it too bright, then either they will be too bright for the background, or I will make them like now really the same color as the background, and this is not working. So okay, so I need to cut away some stuff there, make sure that it is. So the other option is to paint these ones darker, well, brighter apparently, to paint them darker so that there is obviously a darker area here that kind of flows in with the bottom part of the clothes there. We'll see. And then make the book even darker. So I don't want it to be black. I want it to be clearly standing out from her clothes. And that might be more tricky. Okay, so the option is to pale it up, but that's not good neither. Choices. So as you can see, I kind of made the book brighter up here. That's because it needs to stand out against the background. However, the book is supposed to be darker than the rest of her clothing. I need to put in her hand there as well. Okay, so that one needs to be better. Better nose. Better, better. Tone it down a little bit and make it less contrasty. And what gives then is that you get the mind will automatically fill in the blanks. This is something that's quite difficult to understand for a lot of people when they see stuff like this being painted. But this entire area is almost just one color, nothing else. Yet it feels like her lip goes out there somehow, but it really doesn't. And that is called an optical illusion. We like those ones. They help. Wait. Yes, I try to learn. I'll try to teach some stuff, because it's not just about being fun to paint and stuff like that. It's, you know, needs to be something educative with it as well. This is how we have fun together. So for this particular piece, I'm leaning heavily on inspiration from a Norwegian guy called Even Amundsen. who's a very, very, very good artist. He's mainly a concept artist, I believe, but he makes some very interesting stuff. So I've been looking all of his, and he has this fantastic series called that he made a book for called Tane, which means signs in Norwegian, but it also means to draw. So it's a nice little world word game there. And he had a successful Kickstarter, and then he's now running a second Kickstarter, which is quite nice, actually, that he's managed to get to that. Like that one. I like when people who are good at what they're doing succeeds with things. I'm temporarily removing her her eyebrows here. That's because I'm gonna paint them in later. But need to make sure that the face really looks good. I need to make sure the face looks good. There we go. She needs to look really, really happy about this one, because that's kind of what I'm going for. I'm so happy to have the book, because books are happy stuff. Excuse me. So no frowning, just pure happy. And same goes for the, I'm gonna be adding the hair back in later as well. Well, if it helps your GM, why not? Is this a long-running game that you have with this character? Or is it the character that just is your favorite character of all the ones that you've had so far? Because that one happens as well. Over a year, nice. So now we're getting that snuggly I love you book feel here. Game started not long after I moved to Manchester. Oh, nice. So it's a new friends type of game, I would assume then. And she does love books, good. Right. They're a very lovely bunch. That's nice. We like lovely bunches. Well, you know. Let's see. So the video from yesterday, it took a while to upload it, but I believe that it should be uploaded right now because it needed to. Come on. I needed to have it. It needs to be processed or something first. And that one took a while. Let me just check whether it's actually up there. It is. It's up there. It's just an hour long. Just shy of an hour. Whereas today is already 1.5 hours, so. Yes, you can. You can watch it on your way home. Okay, and then a little bit of this. So this is the moment when I'm trying to not get too bright over here, because then I'm gonna have to paint in all the details that I'm carefully kind of removed. But I believe. I believe. I believe that we are getting somewhere with this one. Bit of an old request, but would you and Natasha consider doing tutorials by commission? Neil is struggling with drawing hands and wondering if it would be worth spending about an hour going through something like that with him. Yeah. I don't know if how much Natasha would do that one, because it needs to fit with her schedules and stuff like that. But I kind of am up for that one. It's not the cheapest though. I would need to look into how to actually make it a fair deal for everyone, because tutorial like in, you know, doing a tutorial video like this, that doesn't really take that much effort. Doing hands-on practice and stuff like that, that's requires a lot more of preparations and stuff like that, so you might not actually be paying for just 1 hour, you might actually be painting for a lot more, and that's where it gets difficult to say whether I can give you a fair deal or not. But I can look into that one and see what gives. If it would tickle your fancy. Maybe just think it over for now. Yeah, absolutely. I'll think it over. I'll talk to Natasha about it as well because, you know, smart like that. This is where the light from the side will hit. And so it becomes kind of important to make sure that this one, this is not, I'm not rendering right now. I'm just trying to get the layers to the values to be correct. But is that on my screen or is that on the, it is on the back. So, what are we gonna do this one? Right. Deselect, merge down. I will be posting some work in progress on this one. Is that on okay, Felicity? Posting them on my on the studio account and stuff like that. Because that'd be grand. If I could. I will be posting. Can I post work in progress of these ones on the studio and stuff? So obviously, I'm. The video is being shown and stuff like that, but that's not the same as a. As actually showing off things. Yes, okay, good. Then I will. Right, so that one goes there. This looks weird. I need to check a proper reference I have for cloth folding. Cloth folding. There we go. That would be that one. Okay. Not like that. Come down like this. All right. So yeah, that was wrong. Start over. Let's do this one on top of it. And have this one go as it should, which would be like this. So, and it would stretch all the way over there, and this one would, like that, come up there, and at the highest peak here it would be a little bit more, and then they go together here, and that way we get what is called a cloth fold. So I need to make sure that this cloth fold actually goes as it should, because it's God, I love this song. It's sorry, I say that one every time I think I hear this song, but it's a good song. It's a good piece of music. It's from the it's from Guy Ritchie's it's not this one, but this one is good as well. It's from Guy Ritchie's Arthur story, Arthur movie. And it's good. It's just very nice music in that one. That film was weird? I don't know. I didn't think it was weird at all, to be quite honest. I just... You had to kind of leave your preconceptions about... Or your pre-knowledge about the entire storyline. The King Arthur storyline. And just... follow with it, kind of. Go with the flow. So here's where I'm gonna do... Add some hair. How did I... Oh, good. That's not good. Open. Open. This one. So I had hair on her that went down a little bit like that. It's not a good one. I should open the other one. The giant snake towards the end seemed to literally come out of nowhere. Well, it depends on how you see it. I mean... Oh no. Open. I see. Okay, so never mind. I liked how the snake came out, but it's also, you know, you need to accept that there is magic involved. And if you accept that there's magic involved, I think that one works kind of. It did come out of nowhere. Because it's magic. But yes. Not like that. Blah. So, not like that. Actually, I need to fix this one first. I'm going ahead of myself here a little bit. First, I need to make sure that she has her earrings back, the ones I had put in her ear, because. And to be able to do that one, I actually need to pull off the shoulder cover thingies. Shoulder cover thingies of doom. And the stars on the hat. But the stars on the hat I'm gonna do there. But I cannot put the earrings in here up until I have fixed this part. And I cannot put the hair up until I fix the rings. The stars I can put afterwards though. But yes, otherwise it is indeed not a wizard's hat. Okay, let's see what we get. So I need to fix this one, which will be coming out this one. little bit out so I can actually see it proper. So here is where I'm gonna start doing some random design chisel. So don't freak out. I'm not committed to anything here. It's just a matter of trying to figure out a good look. Ah yes, Carrion Flowers by Chelsea Wolf. This one is also a really good song. I really like this one. Because it brings out something interesting. I'm gonna make these ones metal. Because metal. Because of that one, I'm gonna add a little bit of texture, and then I need this brush. Okay, and then we make this one up here be black, except for when it goes in where it is black, because there we need to show that it's not black. So and then the further down here we get, the darker it gets, except the actual rim of it. So if I now do this one, then I'm actually making it curve a little bit. Because this is what the lights tell us, is that at this point, it goes out to meet the light, comes up from here. So let me see here. So out here, the light is coming from there. Oh, the light is coming from there. Something like that. And because of that one, I'll keep this one so that I can actually move this one around. Because of this one, I need to make sure that the light that comes here, if it's all curved away, like curled in, then it gets all dark like here. And it might actually get even darker depending on how far curled in it is, so down here. But then, if it folds out again, then it will catch the light again. And then it will catch at its shiniest when it has this flat surface. So if I make flat surfaces out of everything, then I have a flat surface that is going here. I don't even know why this one works like this now. That's my light color boss. Somehow that one hits home like that. Fine. Anyway, that's one plate, and then I have another plate here. And I have a third one here. And then I have a small one there. And then it flips out here. One here as well. So if I know that this one looks like this, and that's where the big light hit, well, specifically close to there, then I know that it will hit not there, but like furthest out. So this is what we will try to do. I'll try to make it, and then if I make it flip out everywhere, Then I can actually do this one as well. I can actually make it have like an edge here as well. And the strongest light will hit here because the edge is here and it correlates to where this one is. Hello, love. Welcome. I'm glad you could pop by. So in case you didn't know, Felicity Fliat is Natasha. And we were chatting a little bit about this book-loving goblin. How to make lights. Appear. It's also good that you arrived now because I'm gonna do this one for half an hour longer. So you don't miss it. Yes, and her dragon. Indeed. Dragon is down there. He's looking kind of haha right now. Test and enjoy the background, that's fine. Yay, it's cute. That's actually what I was going for, so I'm glad. So, let's see. Now, to make this one more interesting, I would do something like this. Let's put like one of these ones here. Let's not put it like that though. Let's stroke that path. And then we do this one as well. And then we get something interesting. Well, I shall be doing 10 more minutes of this, and then I will be doing maybe 20 more minutes after that one. But I will not be able to type that much because it takes a lot of time to type. But I still enjoyed having a little conversation whilst you could. And I'm glad that you could drop by. It means a lot. And it does actually mean a lot. I'm not just saying that one because I'm... Enjoy just watching, that's good. Alright, so... we're gonna make the... background, and it needs to be brighter. Why are you not brighter there? Because it's hitting the light from there is a light from behind as well, and that one is hitting everywhere. So on this one I'm gonna make as well the hat. Like so. Let's see. And fill out. It's good that you're here to enjoy watching anyway. And you know, feel free to ask questions. It might take me a while to reply to them though, but if you can't hear me. As long as you're aware of that one. We're gonna get along just fine, even if you have to go back to not listening to me. There you go. I'll try to talk anyway, because it's more interesting to watch it afterwards if I talk. And if I'm just silent, you know, that's like the worst. Here we go, let's see. Yay! Okay, like that, and then this part here will have a bit of as well. As it turns away from the light from behind there. See if we can make this one into something interesting. It's actually working out quite well, that one. And then as it goes over to the other side, I believe that there will be a teeny, teeny hit there. And then just general edginess here. Edginess is good as well. Something like that. Save as, because we need to save at least 3 times. So now I'm actually gotten to the part where I can go. Can actually go in and do the earrings, I think. Yes, let's go in and do the earrings. So, let's... just keep a nice and steady idea on where the lights hit, and this one is easy, easy peasy. So up close like this, it actually gets a little bit blurry and stuff, but this is not the way it's supposed to look. It's supposed to be this size. Actually merge those ones down, and we got ourselves something good. Merge down, merge down, and save, and then we can do another earring. we try to do it a little bit better than what we just did. Well, we try to do it at least as good as we did it just 2 seconds ago. Here's the thing though, because of these ones being metal or gold, we need to catch that light from out there as well. Somewhat. Let's need this one. Even though this one isn't metal, it still needs to catch some of the light. Alright. Think one more ring to rule them all. One that we put down here, far, far below. Heading back to the office, I need to mute this one again. That's fine. Thank you for watching it and talking to me anyway, so far. And keep on watching. I'll be doing this one for 15-20 minutes more, something like that. There's some time. Like this, and now we can start looking at 50%. That looks decent. And then we start adding the hair, or try in any case. Die trying. Excuse me. I just realized that if light hits from up there, there will be a see-through light. There'll be a little bit of a what's it called? Light that comes through from the other side. Like that. Right. down a little bit. And now we can start putting the hair there, which I wanted to do earlier. So a little bit of rustle hair. That's not good. We're gonna do it differently with that one. I need to have good hair. I had good hair. Why? What happened with that one? Where did that one come from? Oh yeah, it came from there. So that would be... from the reference. So let's see if we can make this one happen. Something like that. And this one is actually already good. I just need to find a good way to represent the hair's shininess. Be done. Like so. Like that. Not like that. Right. And a little bit of an eyebrow as well might work, no? Something like that. Back to the softer lip. Pretty happy about the face, to be quite honest. And the head. Let's see if we can add some, some stars to the hat. I'm just gonna make all of those things flatten. Save as, because we need to back up stuff. So That's one. I have one here as well, maybe. Da, 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 da. So now it just looks like I'm erasing stuff, but that's not true. I'm just... using the color, the value that's the background up here. So what the... That was bloody stupid though. Because I was painting on the wrong place. Okay. Not like that. Let's give this here. Let me do this one. There we go. This one can go. We got this one. Let me do this. And we remove this one. No. And we open this one. Okay, try again. Let's paint on the right layer this time. So, then this one. Now, because I have done this one, I can mask that one out, and then we can make sure that it gets brighter in the center, maybe brighter here, and maybe a little bit darker here, maybe a little bit darker here, and maybe like really shiny. Something like this. Save as, because it's... Let's do that one when we're winning. Ten-ish more minutes and then I'm gonna be stopping for today. Okay, so we Yep, that one. I think that one should go. Can go that one as well. No. Save as. Okay, how are we looking on that level? We are looking decent. We go overlay, and then we go on this one. Is this one too? That's good. Layers, save as. Let's do another overlay of this one. That's not good. Let's not do overlay then, normal. That's just one horn. I need another one. Like a glove. So, just adding some touches to the teeth. There we are. Can we look at this one and see if we can get something fun out of it? Yes, we can. So, that's already looking more interesting. So I'm actually on the cusps of ending this stream. It's pretty much comes to an end now. I wanted to do one thing more before I stopped. I wanted to add a wing because we need to have wings. So we shall have one sticking up there. Just one wing. The other wing can be hidden or folded or whatever. But the one wing to rule them all, kinda. Something like this. There you are. This might be way too much, but then we tone it down. perhaps. I am not convinced, so let's remove those ones. Need a proper wing. That doesn't look too intrusive on the background and stuff, because I don't want to change the background now, everything else hangs on it. Changing the background now would mean, you know, changing everything on the figure as well, so it's not too dull. Somewhere along the line there should be a proper reference. Excuse me. Come on, I want to do this one before stopping today. Well, if I can't do that one, then at least I'll do this. I'll add in a little thing to show that this one is a proper dragon. Because he is a proper dragon. He's just small. Small as he is, he will still have teeth. Something like that. Come on. I think we can safely say that this one is gonna be it for today. Yes, I am going to stop at that one for today. But thank you so much for watching. I'm gonna type here as well. Thank you so much for watching. And Tomorrow is Wednesday. No streams on Wednesday. Then Thursday, Friday, I will be streaming more stuff, but then it will not be this one. It will be back to Wildgeist, because we need to finish up that big boy before the end of the month, before the 25th, actually. So that's what we're going to be doing. Streaming the Wildgeist painting. So that's it. I am really grateful that you guys were here today, and I will talk to you next time. Bye.